Pastor Joe here. Give me about 5 minutes of your time today, and let me kind of share with you some things that have been happening and things coming up as well. First of all, a shout out to Pastor Tom Dykus and the folks at Second Baptist Church, Clarksville, Arkansas. I was up there right the week before Easter doing a prophecy conference, and it was a great time in the Lord, and God really moved there. I really do believe we had a great season of ministry there. Coming home, getting ready for Easter, that's always an exciting time of the year. We've been getting ready for Easter, though, for some time. You've heard it in our e-blast. You've heard it from the pulpit. We started sometime in January meeting regularly with all our staff, pastors, directors, communications people, just getting ready for this season. The idea was not just to get a big crowd. We always want to do that at Easter. We want to do that every Sunday. But the goal ultimately was to bring people to Christ, bring them into a relationship with Jesus, and those who do have a relationship with Jesus, to take them deeper in their walk with the Lord, and to launch something Easter that would just carry on out as we got into the rest of the year. We started with a sermon series called Knowing God. We are continuing that series in our Lift group. So there's a lot that was started and begun on that day, and it was done so successfully. But again, it's because so many of you committed to help. I mean, just looking back over, thinking of all the multiple preparation meetings that we did have with staff and others and volunteers, those of you who just so faithfully worked hard to make it happen, God bless you. Thank you again. The volunteers that were used between services, for services, ushers, greeters. I mean, we had probably 80 to 100 volunteers that had to step up and do what needed to be done to make these services go successfully as they did. Close to 400 in attendance for that. With COVID going on, that is just a phenomenal thing. I am elated, excited, and praise the Lord for you guys who worked so hard to make it happen. I also want to thank those who, you know, did the posting on Facebook, those who continued to share it on their social media sites, YouTube. We did a lot of aggressive promotion in those arenas as well as our local signage. And we not only did that, we printed up thousands of invite cards that were handed out by each and every one of you, by so many of you that invited friends and family. People came because that invite card was given to them. Then our Pray and Go team that went over prayed about a week or so before Easter, just into two neighborhoods and around 400 plus homes, went door to door, just not knocking on the door, but just going up and having a word of prayer for those families that live in those houses, going down the street, praying for each house as they went, leaving an invite for Easter, and letting that house know that Believers Fellowship Church is in the community and is there to pray for them and care for them and make a difference in their life. So thank you for all those who stood in line to do that. We're going to be continuing that ministry as well. But the prayer meetings that we had, special meetings for Easter that we called, all the prayers that were sent in and posted on the prayer walls for those things. I mean, I could just go down a list there, and it's just a whole lot that would happen. But when it happened, God blessed it. The Bible tells us the fields are wide into harvest. Pray for laborers. Thank God that God sent laborers and you responded to being the laborer that God called to be a part of work in the fields that are in our community. So again, I cannot thank you enough or celebrate enough or praise the Lord enough for the kind of people God sends us to Believers Fellowship. You're a blessing. You just keep on keeping on. We also, as I said, began a new series. This was to carry us beyond Easter on the Knowing God series, which we're also doing a Knowing God lessons in our Lift groups for the next 6 to 8 weeks. We had a lot of new people sign up for Lift groups that hadn't been coming, so we're expecting growth to continue there. People will be coming back to be a part of the series on Sunday morning as well for Knowing God. Two different things they're doing there. So one is a series on the names of God, and another is just on discovering intimacy with the Lord in your own personal life, how to have a deeper relationship with Him. So there's just a lot of good stuff, as best I can put it, that's going on that'll carry us into Mother's Day just a few weeks away. We have a photo booth set up. You know, if you've been wanting to get that family photo, you've been just putting it off. We have some great photographers and a photo booth that you can come and sit in, and they'll shoot some photos for you. We'll show you how you can get those and download those offline, so you'll have your own digital copy of those family photos, and you can take them and have them printed however, whenever you want to, or Photoshop them, whatever you'd like to do with them. But that's coming up. So families get together for Mother's Day, and it's always a great day of celebration anyway. So come and let's honor our moms and our grandmoms in the church, and let's just be with them and attend church with them and then get that photo. I know that's what every one of them want anyway. So be there. But that's going to carry us on into the rest of the year with all that's coming up. We're getting back more and more things on our scheduled events so that we can do greater ministry in people's life. There's some other things that are happening soon. I'll be telling you about some things that we're trying to be involved in to make a difference in our church and also in our community and in our world. There is a men's event coming up, Magnolia Campus, Friday night. There's a meal and a time of fellowship and ministry. Go to our event page to see that on bfchurch.com. Also our Facebook page and our webpage. But also there's a ladies event coming up about a week after that at the Magnolia Campus, and a ladies event coming up shortly after that at the Spring Campus, a men's event coming up at the Spring Campus, camps and children's camps and youth camps. Get online and check those out. Get registered if where you need to register for some of those camps. And hey, God's good. And I'm excited. Let me just have a word of prayer for you before we dismiss today. Lord, I love you and I thank you for all these folks you've sent to be a part of our church who labor and they minister and they reach out, Lord, and touch people's lives and they make a difference. May you bless them greatly this day. May you just, Lord, help us to receive, Lord, all that you're doing and understand what you're doing, even in our lives today. Give us eyes to see, ears to hear what's going on right in front of us, Lord, and sometimes we so easily miss. Open our eyes to what you're doing in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Your pastor loves you too. Amen.